Hi everyone, Leslie Ray here with Leslie Ray's Crafty Gig. It is Friday the 13th, which is always a fun day for me. Usually it's a pretty productive day, and I've had a very productive day, and so I want to end my day with a little art journaling. I haven't worked in my journal for a long time, and so I'm going to go ahead and play in it some. Right now I'm test driving some new gesso. I'm going to show you in a minute more about that. It's kind of weird. But let me show you what I worked on last night in case y'all hadn't seen it on my blog yet, because it's really pretty. I really like it. So this is what I did last night. It's on the blog. Let's see. What is in the way? This ribbon is in the way. And this is just a plain old journal. And what got me started at this is I shared a link earlier. I can go back and share it this weekend sometime. But there is a group of people getting together some journals, and they want art journals, not journals like this. They want actual art journals with sketch paper or something like that in it. But they're getting together journals, and they want you to decorate them so they can send them to servicemen and women. And you can find your favorite writing pen to send with it. And you write a little note to them on the inside and send it. So I did this, and on the blog you can kind of see some pictures of it. But what I started with was just plain old packing paper. Got it on here with the fast finished decoupage, and then started layering on doilies and real doilies and pieces of metal and pieces of chipboard, and then putting bling on chipboard. Let's see if you can see that up even closer. Just got it real nice and dimensional. These are little pieces of metal down here. This is where I bubbled the gesso and the paper. This is just some more of the, just doily. And this doily was a crochet doily that I got like in the dollar bin at Michael's. So just adding bunches of yummy goodness. Got it all coated in white. And then I started building up here. And this is some of my, these are felt little coasters that I got at the Dollar Tree. And all of these flowers in here, if you go to the blog and look, all of these are Dollar Tree flowers. And these are little Dollar Tree berries, and when you get them really hot, they kind of melt and wrinkle, which is kind of fun. And what I did is I coated everything with gesso and got it all dry, and then I just misted it. I just used bunches and bunches of spray mists and misted it on top of it till I got it a good base coat of what I wanted. And you'll see a picture in there before I start putting on the Maya Rhodes mist. But the first mists I use are the plain Ranger's Delusional Sprays. And there's no mica in those. And then I went in with some Maya mist that has mica in it. And then I finished it off with just some mica powder actually put into the crevices and stuff. Two reasons for the mica powder is it was still a little damp. It didn't dry completely, and it would adhere to that and then kind of make a finish, kind of like putting powder on when you're sweaty or something like that, that kind of theory. But also by heat setting it when this was wet and it picked up the stuff, this will rub off just a little, but not like it would if I hadn't heat set it. So I kind of love how this turned out. Practical, yes or no? Probably, if you're not writing on this side. I didn't want to get it too much more dimensional than this. It's pretty dimensional for the front cover, but it's all good, I think. I like it anyway, and I like how it glimmers and shimmers, and I like how the when you put the metallics on there, it almost is like it tries to break apart and make a kind of you can almost see, you know, the flecks within stuff. So I just like it. I like how it turned out. I like it. I like it a lot. Not my most favorite thing I've done lately, but, you know, in the top 12. So, but in the course of doing that, this sweet little bottle of gesso that I've had for ages, I was almost out of. And as you read it, it says Liquitex acrylic gesso, gesso acrylic, gesso acrylico, gesso acryl, gesso acrylico. Okay. Acrylic gesso, right? Liquitex, yes. So I went to the store and I could buy this little bottle for the same price as this ginormous Liquitex Basics bottle. And it's basic Liquitex acrylico gesso, yes. But instead of the nice opaque finish that I get on my paper, this is the finish I get. And it's very odd. And I don't know if I like it or not. But we're going to try it. So, normally when I paint with my gesso, one coat and the bad boy's covered. I've put one coat on here. And just because I think I want some of these places a little more opaque, and I'm going to go over paint, so I guess it's the purpose of it is to serve as a prep to take more paint. So I guess in that regard, it's probably going to be just fine. But my brain tells me it's white gesso. It should work, right? Don't say gesso. It's gesso acrylico. So in my brain, I need to go over these pictures just one more time. I'm sure it's not necessary, but it feels necessary. So that's what I'm doing. But this year, even though one of my, what do you call them, resolutions to myself was to do my monthly calendar in my planner here, I have been remiss. And I was doing pretty good for a while, getting at least an art journal page a month done, because I was doing some, what do you call it, the challenges. A friend of mine has a mixed media challenge and I was participating in those, and so I got to use that as an excuse to work in my journal, and I haven't even had time to do that. So Fab is asking if this has a sheen. No, Fab, it doesn't. It's very it feels granular and powdery, which gesso kind of does anyway. If you look at people who've made homemade recipes for gesso, like Amanda has and stuff, powder is one of the main ingredients in it to make it have that kind of an accepting surface to take on paint and, you know, as a prep. So, but anyway, it's just weird feeling to me because I'm used to a very opaque gesso and this is more transparent. And they even have clear gesso, and I know that will never be in my vocabulary because, like I said, I want it to feel like I've coated this, and it doesn't. Yes, Jim, we have video. Maybe hit reset. So, anyway. But what I'm going to play with tonight are some acrylic paints and I might mist. I don't know. Right now, everything in my workspace right now has just a light mist on it. It's very lovely. But I also want to play with some foam stamps. These look fantastic. I got these at Walmart, of all places. And I have some bigger ones, but these were just a cute size. 'Cause see, look, like I've got, my thumbnail. It's the size of my thumbnail. So it's all good. I really like these. The only problem I had with these, and you can see it in the F, is that finding a set of these that was not messed up in any way. This was the best set, and the F has a little globber in it, but I will deal with that. So I'm gonna use these to write September when I get the base down. So let's work on getting the base down. How's that sound? I think it is a thinner gesso, fam. I don't know. I'm gonna relax and just kind of go with it and see how it feels when I start putting more product on top of it. So I hope it feels better in a minute. Okay. I want to get kind of a base colors. September is what I'm dealing with. September to me is a red month. I think of back to school, even though that's August. So I want to use a little red. Something I can put. And this is my my sad little brush. It's a just a plain old Royal Lane nickel. It's actually a pretty good brush, but I've just about worn it out doing stuff like this. So that's not dry. I should have dried that. Let's work on the side of the page first. It's got some dry to it. But anyway, yeah, I've been doing lots and lots of projects. I tried out recently for a couple of design teams. Some I didn't make, but I was okay because the one I really, really wanted to make, I did make. And that was the Cheerylin design team. And those are the people that make those fantastic flower dyes that I love, love, love. And so I get to play with their product a lot, and I'm very excited about that. So I'm waiting for my new team member package to come in the mail, and so as soon as that comes, I will share that with you, and we will start doing some fun stuff with the Cheerylin dyes because they have so many really fantastic dyes, and of course, their flowers are to die for, and fortunately, I have a ton of flower dyes coming in my welcome package. And then they have all kinds of neat dyes that stack and work together that are really neat, and I can't wait to get started with those. Okay, so this is coating pretty good. Granted, I'm using Ceram Coat, which Ceram Coat is usually a thicker body paint anyway, but I won't have to put a second coat on this. This is coating really, really well. So I like that.
So I hope everybody is doing good tonight. We're all doing good. I think everybody's back in the swing of the new school year. It's such a neat year this year. Lots of cool stuff with the family. Welcome new people that see Marie and Zanesville Blue. Welcome to the show. I'm just painting along here, enjoying myself. This is my upcycled art journal. And what I've done is I've upcycled a brochure from my office. By day, I am a travel specialist, and my night job is to art and craft and create. And so I got these brochures, and they are wonderful. And they're made with recycled materials, and upcycling is one of my favorite things to do. And so I had been watching many artists do their brochures, or not brochures, but do their art journaling on a simple composition book, much like the one I showed you earlier. And I thought, well, if they can do that and use paint or gesso to, you know, cover up all the lines or use the lines whenever necessary, then why can't I use a brochure? And so I've been doing this, I guess this is maybe my third year to use an upcycle brochure, and I enjoy it. I love it. So if you want a brochure, you can get one of two ways. You can call the company, and this company is called Nat Habitat, and just call and tell them you want a brochure. They have their new brochures out this year already. I just got one in the mail. Its cover is not as luscious and yummy as the cover on this year's is, but it's more of a, it's got a glossy kind of finish on it, but the inside papers are just as great as these are and will work wonderfully for a journal. So maybe Jim will give it another try. Maybe somebody go hijack him off of Facebook and tell him to give it another try. And of course, I am recording. Yes, I am recording. So Jim can find me later. He may just be tired too. I would be tired if I just got back from Alaska recently. I'm jealous. I want to go to Alaska. I think we all should go to Alaska. So, I want to go see the birds in Alaska. Although, I just finished a trip plan for these people that are going to Branson, Missouri. And everybody says, oh, you know, oh, Branson, yeehaw. But they are taking several kind of nature tours that sound really fantastic. And they're taking a train ride and a lake ride in a steam paddle boat thing that specializes in showing the flora and the fauna and all that kind of stuff. So that sounds pretty neat, and I wouldn't mind doing that at all. So, and now you can zip line in Branson. How about that? And they have an Eagles tribute band. Does that sound like fun? If you like the Eagles. Would y'all like some Eagles trivia? Anyone? I'll share it with you anyway. Y'all will answer in a minute, and somebody will say, "Oh yes, please share with us." We have a station in the Metroplex area called KEGL, the Eagle. And when I was growing up, it played top 40 rock, and we listened to it pretty regularly. Well, the folks who owned KEGL, they moved or sold the station to somebody else who thought they would decide to make a whole station of nothing but Eagles music. And so every hour, every day, every month, Eagles play. The Eagles, the Eagles, the Eagles. Now, if you love the Eagles, I'm sure that's a great thing. And I do appreciate the Eagles, and there are several songs that I enjoy, Hotel California being one of them. We lived out in the country, probably 15, 20 minutes away from the grocery store. And we got out to the car with our groceries. And, of course, turned the car on so that it would cool down. And, lo and behold, Hotel California is playing. And we listened to Hotel California all the way to our house. And Hotel California continued to play for a solid hour. Nothing but Hotel California played on that radio. Back after back after back after back. And it was crazy. And we couldn't believe it. Unless you'd heard it with your own ears, you'd go, "Nah, that didn't really happen." Yeah, it really happened. Of course, that was also the same radio station that thought it would be amusing to play "Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer" at Christmas time for a solid hour also. So, they were kind of weird. But, what can I say? I won't panic, Fab. Okay, my pictures that I was worried about, that I were worried about getting covered up, have covered up very nicely. So I just have to get over the fact that this gesso is more about the providing a surface than it is about coding the words. Does that make sense? Hi, Carrie. Welcome. Okay. I want to add some hot pink in there because it's my journal and I want some hot pink. So I'm going to add a little, it's really fuchsia is what Ceram Coat is calling it. So we're going to add that in. I don't know what's up with the internet. Fab is talking about his is in training. He had new broadband and stuff. And Mom said her switched to dial-up. Last week, we came in and we had no internet service. Even though we had phone service, we had no internet service. And we called our company. And they told us, "Oh, no, it's not you." And they did all this troubleshooting. And they weren't going to be able to send a person out for like 2 days. It was a long time. And so we said, "Well, what's he gonna do?" She says, "Well, I'll have him bring a modem." We said, "Well, can you just overnight us a modem?" And they said, "Sure." So they overnighted us a modem. And we have great neighbors who let us borrow their Wi-Fi. And we were able to hop along on Wi-Fi. And but our voice over IP was kind of precarious, so we had our phones forwarded to our cell phones and stuff. And we hopped along on that, and it was obnoxious. And then the next day, before we even got our new modem, our internet was back. And so during the day, we had a couple of people come in and said, yeah, I was having problems with my CenturyLink too. It seems to be better now. So basically, CenturyLink was having issues. But of course, you know, nobody at the office knew that. And so I guess they were just sending out random modems for the day. Fortunately, it's part of our plan and we didn't have to pay for it. But my goodness. When are y'all gonna have triple win, Feb? That sounds like fun. So, school starts, and Fancy Pants is playing volleyball. She has her first game in a week or two. And Will is in band and ag, and he has his first, he has, next week is a big music week. He has his first pep rally for 8th grade. He played in pep rallies in 7th grade, but not as much. He got to play, I guess they played in the last one or two, but most of 7th grade, the band just kind of hung out. In 8th grade, the band gets to jam and be the pep rally music. So the band will play their first pep rally next week. And then also next week, they are practicing with the big band over in the high school. And they will have a big rehearsal with them. And then on Friday, they will play the first game of the season in what they call a side-by-side. And they won't be marching on the field, but they'll be playing in the stands with them, the fight song and school song and stuff like that. So it will be great fun. And we are all looking forward to it. So next week is a big week. We have our first game. We'll have first home football game. We've already had some off-season game, or not off-season, but preseason games that we're not going to talk about because they were very sad. And then this will be our first season game. So everybody's excited about the football. We're excited about the band. So if you have nothing to do in the area, want to come listen to the band, come on out. Next week we have band every day. Every day next week we have band practice or rehearsal or lessons or whatever. So, okay, now the pink that I'm putting on, same company, but I can still see the words up over here some, but I'm thinking that's okay with that. And I think I want a little orange in there too, guys. Ooh, no, not orange. This is what I want. I want some copper. Ooh, copper. Ooh, copper. So, are y'all enjoying watching the paint dry? Anybody have any questions about paint drying? See, first you apply the paint, and then you let it dry. I know, it's crazy.
I'm gonna get some copper on there, and then I'm gonna heat it with my heat tool. Or zap it with my heat tool. There we go. Oh, that's lovely. This paint I'm using, don't kill me, it's called Eco-Friendly Eco Green Craft Paint, and it's probably one of the nicer paints I've played with in a long time. And of course they decided to get out of the paint making business, so they no longer make paint. Mom found me a whole bunch at Tuesday morning and got it for me, and I really like it, and I really wish they would not have quit making paint, because they've also quit making ink, which is one of my favorite ink makers, is the Paris Trunk inks, and they've decided to quit making Paris Trunk inks as well. So there you go. So see, and just a little bit of copper here and there. No rhyme or reason, just some fun. So I like that right there. So I'm gonna zap the heat gun. So if you're wearing headphones, heat tool. Hi Teppy, welcome. Feel free to jump in. Oh, joy. I refuse to watch Honey Boo Boo. I love you, Joy, but Honey Boo Boo, really? Joy, say it's not so. No. I do like those colors together, though. Orange and pink and turquoise. I do like those colors a lot. So, I can imagine they were gorgeous. Paula, Mom, Honey Boo Boo is not allowed here. Yeah, we. I've only seen, like, you know, when it gets really super alarmist and they'll post something. I've only seen anything Honey Boo Boo related in that regard. So, I haven't seen it any other way. Okay, I'm reaching under here for my stencil that I just got. There we go. No, we're not using the flowers for the stencil. I mean, the snowflakes on the stencil. I know it looks like we should because, you know, it's snowflakes. And hey, snowflakes are good for every occasion, right? But we're not doing snowflakes today. We are instead going to get out my little piece of cardboard here that I used for some actually I'm gonna do this and do that. And I might use the edging here, I think. You had to peek at the wedding. That just makes me cringe. Okay. That's all I have to say about that. Okay. I am going to use this new stencil. That's what this is, a stencil. But I don't want to use the snowflakes. I mean, you know, I jest that snowflakes are a year-round event, but we're not using them today. Okay. And I want to use, I have an orange mist and a yellow mist. I think I want to try the orange mist. Let's see. Okay, let's try. Do that. And then put that up. Ooh, that's kind of cool. I like how that turned out. I'm going to dry that before I put down some more stuff. Yes, no judging here. If you like Honey Boo Boo, that is your option. And, you know. Apparently, there are so many people that do like it. That's why it is on the air. So, you're definitely not alone. I don't have real television anymore. I watch Netflix or Amazon Prime. And like with the new season of television, if it's something I really like, I will watch it after it's shown on regular TV or they reshow it on the internet. So, yeah. I take a lot of guff for liking things like Survivor, you know, so. You are not alone. It just left this hint, guys, of, let's see if you can see it, just a smidge hint of that on there. So, okay. I'm going to do the same thing on the opposite corner. It's not going to go all the way around. It's just going to be a hint of color here and there. So I'm going to go right here. And before I get carried away, I'm going to take my towel here that I have just for this purpose and dry it off. And dry off the side too, apparently. Okay. Or maybe this side will just have this special kind of little sticky. Okay. It'll be good. We will be fine. Here we go. And we'll go right here. Your grandkids are not allowed to watch it. I understand, Joy. I completely understand. Okay. Let's do something fun before this dries. Let's see if I can find. There we go. This one is clear. Yes. how this works.
I am putting on here some clear emboss powder just to see what this does.
If it does what I think it will do, I will be very pleased. Oh yes, it does. Okay. So
I put some clear emboss enamel on top of the wet on this side, which is the right hand side of my book. If anybody wants to know that. So it'll give it an interesting little texture where it melts into the paint. And in some places where the paint is, it's going to bubble just a little. And that's good too. I found a new cool tool today that I should have played with for this page, but I didn't. Sometimes I like to have look at those color inspirations kinds of pages. And there's Adobe has a page where you can take a picture that you like. And I know there's probably several of them out there.
But you take a picture that you like and you... you put it into this program and it picks out colors. And so this one picked out some really cool colors and I liked playing with it. And but I thought about it, I would have done it for this page and tried to match it with my paint. But instead, I'm having fun doing this. Look at that. Isn't that fun? I like that. So what I want to do is to put September on this side with my little stamps. So let's get out some stamps here. Okay. Welcome, Pam. Just jump right in. The scrape is pretty laid back and relaxed. We've been together for several years, and so when one of us streams or hasn't streamed in a while, it's like old home week. Everybody's, oh, what are you doing? You know, what have you been up to? So just jump right in, asking questions if you have any. Feel free to comment along. Everybody's nice to everybody and we have a good time. Hey, Jean. Okay, so here we go. I've got my foam stamps from Wally World. How exciting is that? Okay, so let's, dare we go with the gecko? I think we should go with the gecko. Hi, Jean. Glad to see you. Who is Ori? I don't know. Oh, Lori. Hi, Lori. Welcome. Y'all can just guess that I'm going with the gecko. Because, well, it's gecko. Hola.
¿Cómo está?
Bonjour.
¿Cómo se va?
Oh, the paint. Ah, here we go. Gecko, gecko, lagartija, maybe. Yeah, it's hard.
Aw, man. Okay. My gecko paint is kind of like dead gecko. It's very solid in there. It'll work.
Yeah. I had commented on the gesso earlier in all the languages that was written in, and I'm not good with gecko. I can say gesso, and then I can say gesso. You've never seen me with clean. Yeah, I painted myself kind of green yesterday. It was, or last night with my project. I'm telling you, the gecko kind of looks like gecko guts here, guys. Let's see how this works. This doesn't work. I have another kind of leafy green color, but hopefully the gecko works. See. Oh, that worked good. Can y'all see my S down here? Ooh. Lagarta, the lizard. Is that what that means? Lagartija. It's got a tija in there. Like yeehaw, only. It's yeehaw, the lizard, right? Lagartija. Anyway. I have a problem with Spanish because I minored in French, and so my Spanish comes out as French, so we call it Franish. So. Good night, Fab. I'm glad you could join me. Bonne nuit. A bientôt, monsieur. Except apparently the red or the copper or something had a little, you know. Yes, gecko always. I love gecko. Gecko and fuchsia. And see, I hadn't even watched Honey Boo Boo's Wedding. I even bought a gecko colored shirt. Okay. Yes, we do buy gecko by the case. I did not know there was any other way you could buy it. The kids love it too. So after I called mom and said they've stolen my gecko. She got them their own gecko, so we could all have gecko. Maybe this is Will's gecko in my paint bucket instead of my gecko. I knew when I saw these little stamps that they would be perfect for doing just this. Sometimes I like to write my letters. Sometimes I like to stencil my letters. And I've been looking for some little stamps, and these just look like the perfect size. And these are over in the kids section by the kids crafts. If you get little foam stamps, be sure to look through them and make sure you don't get some that have like crease marks and stuff in them, because if they're hanging on the shelf and they still have crease marks, that's bad. You know, it's one thing if you make your own crease marks because you've been, you know, having stuff stacked on them, but if they come from hanging up and down with crease marks, you want to stop that. Now, you will notice I'm not soaking these in water. I'm just rubbing them on my crafty rag, and I'm making sure I get it out of here. This is about as much cleaning as my foam stamps are going to get, for several reasons. One, this is paint. They're made to use with paint. Two, for the whole set, I think I spent maybe $2. Maybe $2. I'm not going to buy a whole nother one. Good night, Jean. Glad you could stop by. So, and if I put these in water, then they suck up all the water and they're just a pain to store. So just rubbing them off, they're for all intents and purposes, they're clean enough. I'll put them in my drawer, and I want to dry that a little bit. Okay. Now, the purpose of this kind of calendar thing is to kind of keep up with the month's events. And like I said, I've been horrible at accomplishing that this month or this year. I got my 2013 on my cover, and I got about that far in January, and my life just got crazy. So, and I painted a page for February, and I painted a page, started painting a page for March, and then life got crazy, and so this is the last time I've been really, really bad. Really bad this year about getting this done. So, but someone did this in theirs and it inspired me and I wanted to do it, so that's what I'm doing. Now I'm going to put my months down. Now in the past, I've done my months a little differently. I've done squares or circles or whatever. This year, I've been kind of doing months haphazardly. And what I'm going to do for the month of September is I'm going to do strips. This one lady did strips and they were so cool and I loved them very much. So I want to do strips. And off the top of my head, I'm not seeing a color that I like, so I'm going to make a color. So this is what we're going to do. Move that aside. I am going to bring out this white cardstock I have up here. And I'm going to make one set of strips. Orange.
So stick this down. With a little bit of pink in them. I have funky fuchsia and I have bubblegum pink. I think I'm gonna go with this bubblegum pink because even though fuchsia's on the book, I think this pink will convey what I want to convey. Okay? And just a little bit of water. There's the water. Night, Mommy. Like that. And these are just the Delusions ink sprays on white cardstock. Okay? Y'all see that all right? And I put down a piece of cardboard to spray on. For my sanity. Now, you can do all kinds of different things from here. Because I want these to be strips that I'm going to number, I don't want to get too carried away with any kind of further ornamentation. I really like that. Can y'all see? I guess you can't see. Can you see now? Sorry about that, guys. As you can see with how the paper curls, it's because there's a lot of moisture on. I sprayed a lot of water just right on top of the orange and the pink to get some of this mixing going on that I have. These do blend nicely. These are a lot of fun. Jean carries these in the store. She has, I don't know that she has all the colors. But I know she has, well, she may have all the colors that are out right now. I think there's like maybe 15. I can't remember for certain. But the colors I used were the sweetened orange and the bubblegum pink for this page. I almost want to scan that. I really like how that turned out. That's so cool. Okay, and that will look fun on my page. And then I have another piece of white paper. And on this one, I am going to spray the, not the cut grass. I'm going to spray. Hang on, going through the drawer here. Aha. Fresh lime. Yeah, I love how bright they are. They are so pretty. Okay. This matches my gecko almost. Now watch this. This is the fun part. On this one, so it'll be closer to my gecko color. You hear the shaker ball? This is the only one of these that has a shaker ball in it. It's the white. And I'm going to do that just a little bit. Add a little bit of that. And a little bit of just plain old water. Excuse me while I spray everything, but what I'm supposed to be spraying. Okay. Yes, and the white spray is awesome. And it kind of gives you a whole other range of colors with the white. Now this had a little bit of overspray right here. I just left that on there because it's cool. They have a black and a brown. I started off getting the midnight blue because it's very dark, like the navy blue, and I got the yellow, and I got the lemon green, or the lime green, of course, and I got pink and fuchsia, and a red that's kind of a Christmas red, and cut grass, which is kind of a Christmas green, and I got white. And I loved them very, very much. And so I kept going, Jean, you got the brown and black, got the brown and black, got the brown and black. And I don't know if she got them to shut me up or if she got them because she was going to. But she has the brown and black now. So we have brown and we have black. And then there's teals and turquoise and purple. It's just, they're a lot of fun. So... getting these last couple of places. And if you want to, you know, stop waiting on paint and just dry it with a rag, you can do that too. Because sometimes that's fun. Okay. So here's my colors. So I love how that turned out too. All the variation in there with the green and the yellow. So, and I love my thing that I'm spraying on, my oversprayer. Okay, so here's these. And I'm going to get me my little cutter right here. And I'm going to cut some strips. And I think I want to make my strips about a half an inch wide. So I'm going to start at 4.5 on my little cutter because it makes it easy. Thank you, Don. I like it. Strips should that give us? And it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Get a couple more strips in there. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. September. 30 days, September, April, June, and November. All right. So I get half or so of these. do these. Ooh. Ooh. Ah. Hi, Carrie. I like that you're crafting along. Are you doing anything fun and exciting? Hi, guest. Welcome back. I know, I love the orange and the pink together, too. And the teal. Or not the teal, but the lime. And, you know, it's not quite that color, but it's close. And if I wanted to, I could have done that paper and then used the embossed powder and a watermark pad and those little stamps and embossed letters and then cut them out. That would have worked really cool, too. I'm going to do that for another one later, but today, this is what we're doing. I saw this. One of the calendar artists did this for her calendar, and I thought, that is too cool. And so, this was inspired by her, and I'll put her name in the description of my video, because I have to go look it up again. But, she did that, and I was just like, you know, that is really fetching, and it looks very pretty. So I have these half-inch strips that I'm cutting, and oh man, all those are fun. Okay, so there we are. We have extra strips just in case. And now, pull this over here. And I'm going to move my mists. My ink sprays and my water bottle and my gecko. I'm done geckoing now. I'm gonna use my Beacon Fresh Finish Decoupage. Now these are gonna look kind of fun on here, I think, because it's kind of going to echo that color, you know. And obviously, I'm not gonna keep them this long. This is just kind of placement of where I want them, and I like that contrast. I think what I want to do is edge them, so let me get them kind of placed, and then I'm going to trim them. Some of them will be smaller than others and shorter, and some of them might be right next to each other. Here's some with some extra orange in it. That's why they can sometimes go together like that. 13, 14, 15. Oh, yeah, step over here. Well, 30 days has September, right? April, June, and November. All the rest have 31. Except in February, which has 28, 29.
Okay. So we have those kind of. So now, let me get some ink. I think.
Sounds good, guys. Let's just use some distress ink. Okay.
I think I want to just use kind of a, like a, maybe black soot on there.
Edge it with, and I'll go ahead and get out my black stick pen to write with.
Okay. All right. So I'm gonna need my scissors. So I'm gonna cut some of these short. Yeah, I think black will look great too. Okay. So, I'm pulling these over to the side and keeping them. Okay. And there's no rhyme or reason to why I'm cutting them the lengths I am. I just kind of want to get a feel for it. That's why I'm putting some, you know, down right to there.
Okay, so there's that side. I think I'll go ahead and edge and glue on this side. Okay, got my fast finish decoupage, but I also have this adhesive dries clear. I think it will hold good holding the cardstock down, and then I'll do a thing over the top of it, I think, with the other. So all I'm going to do is just edge. I'm not going to just kind of run it like that, okay? Not doing a distressed edge. I'm just edging. Which, something I learned at convention, that my action of doing this, because I like to do this sometimes, just edge that white away. If I was doing this with the new Stampin' Up! Pads, I'd be cutting my Stampin' Up! Pad in half, which kind of makes me sad because Stampin' Up! Pads were one of my favorite Juicy Ink pads, and now they've kind of changed how they work. I'm not sure I care for that, so we will see. So hopefully, by my next show, I'll have some of my new die cuts, and we can play with flowers and do all kinds of cool stuff with flowers. That's my thought, and do maybe some Halloween projects or something. I'm going to be participating in a month-long hop with a place called Smeared and Smudged, and they have a month-long hop, so there'll be a new project every day for that hop, and those are stamped projects, which is very cool. And then in addition, I will have my regular posts for Digital Lights and for Altered Pages and for Cheery Lynn and for Just Becauses, because sometimes you have to have a just because. You know, it makes it better because it's just because. Okay, let me just say that I am really liking this very much. And the black edge is just enough, just a hint. I could do it with a marker if I wanted to. Don't have to, but I could if I wanted to. Hi, Melody. Everybody say hi to Melody. She is one of my new Altered Pages teamies. So I'm glad you came by to see me do what I do. This is just kind of my laid back show, Melody, and I'm talking to obviously the guests over there on the side and I do whatever. This is my night to do whatever. I do so many things during the week for different companies. And this is just my crafty gig. Sometimes I mix media. Sometimes I felt. Sometimes I sew. Sometimes I do cards. Sometimes I play with flowers. Just whatever. Whatever moves me. Just has a lot of fun. So, I'm glad you could join us. This is part of a project that I make this commitment every year, and I never can seem to follow it through. And it's a commitment to myself, so it's not like I'm letting down anybody but myself. But there is a group of ladies that do a project where each month they have an art journal page with all of their calendar stuff, and it's a calendar journal. And I always admire it. I think it's such a cool thing. And I keep trying to do it. And so sometimes I'll get to about the middle of the year and give up. And then never come back to it. Well, I was so inspired by one of the artists this month, that I had to do this. And the rest of my months may be a calendar like this because it goes together so quickly and easily. And it's just simple, and I can just do some more writing. If I want to doodle, I can doodle on the side, but I can keep up with the month. And I really was inspired by her project this month because I thought, wow, it was striking and it was just cool. You know, just really, really cool. So that's where I am here, is I mean, this is not exactly like hers, but it's got a big tip of the hat to her. And I appreciate her for getting me out of my slump and helping me to feel accomplished this month, because this is a lot of fun. And I get a lot of pleasure from this. When I go back and I look at the pages that I do get accomplished during the year, I think, wow, that's really cool, you know? I really like them. And so that makes me feel, you know, inspired to do it for the whole year, but then life happens and it just doesn't get accomplished. So here we are, getting accomplished. Yay me. Are you behind? Oh, I'm just inking and stuff. I took a second to take a sip of tea because talking to yourself can be thirsty. A thirsty adventure. So no melody, as you can tell, you know. I'm apparently in England, right? No, I am definitely a Texan. I'm definitely from the South. No doubt about it. So, maybe I'm Canadian. No, I'm not Canadian. But Don's Canadian. Don'll type Canadian with you. I do this about every other week, and usually for at least an hour and a half. Tonight it might go a little longer because I want to finish gluing my strips. So, yes, Dawn, morning glasses, Dawn.
Dawn Melody. And Carrie is Carrie. And Carrie is crafting along in the background. Can't remember who all is left. That may be all of y'all that are here, and then we have a guest lurking over there. And that's okay, unless you want to join us. Earlier we had several friends and family that have had to go on, either eat or tend to family. So, but then my family is in the other room. Tonight's misadventure was the removal of the big couch from the living room. And what I had to do to get the couch in here, it's a giant couch. This couch is almost as old as I am. I'm 44. Couch old, almost as old as I am. Probably just 4 years younger than me. And it was my grandmother's. And she moved it from Mississippi to Texas. And when she finally passed, it moved down here. And which was fine, because it was time for us to have a new couch. Our couch was getting old and decrepit. And, it was time for a new couch. So we gratefully took that couch. Well, Bill and I came to put that couch in the house. And it didn't want to go easily. It took quite a bit of convincing on the part of us to get the couch in, because it's a giant couch, and it had giant cushions and giant arm backs. And when it finally went in was after we had removed the screen and the front door from the house, and just about killed ourselves going through the door. And it was at that night that we determined that it was not coming out in one piece. Not going to. Ever. Again. It came in one piece, but when it goes out, not one piece. So, I found a friend of mine. I've been looking for a couch because this couch, it was time for it to go. And a friend of mine says, I meant to take a couch out this past weekend for the garage sales that we were having and just put on the curb with the word free, but I forgot to. And I said, can I see that couch? And so she sent me a picture. And I said, okay, I want to come look at it. So we came to look at it. And it is an older couch. It's floral-y. It's kind of fun. And it's very sound, very solid, good piece of furniture. And I said, okay, we want it. Because, you know, hello, it's free. And so we brought the couch home. And we haven't had rain for a couple of days. Well, of course, it rained a day or two. And we hadn't gotten the monster out of the house. Finally, I told my husband, it has to come inside. The couch has to come inside. We're going to go to a friend's house this weekend. The couch has to come inside. And so he helped the couch inside. It was great. The chainsaw came into the house. And the couch left the house. So, awesome. I'm
I am tickled beyond tickled that we have the new couch in the house. So you missed the chainsaw sounds in the background. But he cut the back off and him and Will scurried it out of the house. So, ever you need moving tips from Leslie Ray. If you don't like your couch, cut it apart. Right? I'm sure some people will hear that and go, oh, wow, that's very odd, but that's okay. Never claim to be sane. And of course, my kids thought it was great. Mom had us cut the thing out. Okay, I've almost got my ends cut here, and then okay, so here's the second half of the month, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So. Aw, that was nice. Good night, son. Thank your son for serving in the Navy for us. If you're interested, I have anybody can join. This month on the 22nd, I have my very fall steampunk blog hop celebrating the turning of the season to fall. That is, like I said, the 22nd. And then in October, towards the end of the month, I have my very spooky steampunk Halloween blog hop, which of course is Halloween steampunk style. And that one, again, Halloween steampunk. Then in November on Veterans Day, I do a thank you for, you know, serving us for the veterans. And that one is all about thanks and appreciating our servicemen and women. And then finally in December, I do a very merry steampunk holiday blog hop, which serves to do all of Chris Hine Yule. Well, fill out the form in the event for joining. This just, you know, advertising the hop, there is a form in there, Melody, and fill that out, and That is the form for the next 4 block hops, and I will put you in the group and you'll get all the information. So the Veterans Day one is on Veterans Day, and it's for thanking our servicemen and women who have, you know, protected us and fight for us and all that. So I've had many, many family members. My current family, nobody's in the service, but my grandfather on both sides, Bill's grandfather and great-grandfather, my uncle, lots of servicemen and women in our family, so. The form, if you, Dawn, can you find the form for her or the event? The event is posted. There's also probably a form in the APDT group, but Dawn can probably find it also. Sorry, I'm losing y'all. I'm glad y'all came back. Should be able to add a link. Thank you, Dawn. Dawn's not really my secretary, even though I treat her like that sometimes. She's my good friend. I appreciate you, Dawn, very much. I'm gonna edge all of these at once so I can be done edging and then just sit and glue. If nothing else, Melanie, I think I put a link in the AP page, and it'll show you where you can sign up. There's a link to the form. There's a link on my fan page, too. There's a link on my blog. There you go. Awesome. Dawn rocks. Dawn's the coolest. Love Dawn. Thank you, ma'am. And just, you know, fill out the form, and then I'll add you into the Blog Hops group. And they're pretty nice in there. They haven't bitten anybody yet. And then we'll get you hooked up. But I like doing it. And the steampunk blog hops seem to really get a good following. We get a lot of traffic from those, I think. Thank you, Dawn. And also, in April, I always do an upcycled one. And that one always gets a ton of traffic also. So this spring was kind of difficult, so a couple of my blog hops that I had planned, I had to either combine or drop, and I think everybody was okay with that, because I think they got a little hectic in their lives, too, so. Yeah, October is going to be crazy, but it's going to be so much fun, because I did a blog hop last year that was a week long, and I loved it, but it was only focused on one company's products, and so I have lots of things, and I probably have the only thing I have more than snowflake stamps is Halloween stamps, so, you know. It's the first time you ever watched and watched the chat at the same time. Well, welcome, BB. I'm glad you could make it. I'm creating a art calendar page. It's inspired by one of my art calendar peers in a group that I belong to. And she did her art calendar for September like this. And since I have been remiss in getting my art calendars done this year, and I really wanted to, and I got so excited about this one, I decided to give it a go tonight. So but I'm tickled that you got to see it live with the chat going on. See, I'm really not talking to myself, BB. I'm just really people. Really, really. I think some people, one time, someone commented that, you know, too much of this other chatting and why don't I scroll through it fast or whatever? And it's like, well, that's not the purpose of this show. The purpose of this show is, you know, we get together, we art and we chat and try things out and talk and have fun and you know, that's just what it's about. And I like it. I like it a lot. If I was doing just a straight on tutorial, well, I approach that differently. So it is more about let's get the project done and move on. Whereas this is more about, yeah, let's put our hair down, hang out. It's Friday night. We're enjoying it. Yeah. So, but, and I, if I miss some of my favorite streamers, I go back and I watch and I art while they art. And so that they're talking to the people in the group doesn't bother me either. So, I think for this, I'm going to line them up. Well, maybe. I'm going to line them up like this and flip them around. Here we go. And kind of make this a little straighter here. There. And see, these little strips are neat because I could write something or I could do like a little Zentangle border in there. All kinds of fun stuff. So I'm excited about my little strips. And like I was saying earlier, the rest of my months may be all a strip. I never know. So when I'm going to blog about this because I have been trying to do good at that. I think I've been doing good at that. That was one of my blog resolutions for the new year is when I stream, when I get the opportunity to stream, that I try to blog about it afterwards so that I can share products I used or a final page. My friend Tracy over at Mixed Media Monday, she does that and I really like it. So. Not that I want to be Tracy when I grow up, but I do definitely want to make an effort after doing this for 3 years to be better about blogging it because I have a whole audience that follows my blog that probably doesn't realize I do video. So, and in case you ever go looking for your favorite video and it's not still out on the Ustream, go over to my YouTube because I upload them all to my Ustream. And also, when I've done videos for other product companies, I put those on there too. And see, like my show, I was inspired by, you know, a friend in a group. Dawn just wrote that she has been inspired to pull out her mists and make some paper, I hope, because these, way cool. I like the way these turned out. So. Let's see. Want to get another pinky one in here. But I love being inspired from anybody. So always try to connect with me and I like to go and look and see what you're doing because everybody does such neat things and unique things and I think we can learn from everybody. This artist glitter glue is pretty fun. I learned about this from Donna Salazar. It's art glitter, designer, dries clear adhesive. And this company at artglitter.com has all kinds of glue, not just glitter glue. And I went over there and I was pretty wowed by the amounts and types of glue they had. So I'm trying to get more and more people to invest in our bi-weekly show and blog spots and get some products to share with people. I've got some Inca Gold coming to share. Colleen, the wonderful lady who commented to me about my concerns about Inca Gold, the owner of the company in California, is going to send some products for us to share. So I think it will be a good thing. Because, like I said, told her, you know, I really enjoyed the pen. Really wanted to enjoy the Inca Gold and was very sad at the experience I'd had. And she's making it right. So if ever you find yourself having an experience like that, don't go off and pout and go to an ugly place. But, you know, try to make it better. Make it right. Be positive. I was asked, do I like Ustream better? By do I like Ustream better, I'm thinking, you're thinking, do I like it better than the other options for streaming? And yes, absolutely. I have streamed on Link2 with some other of my compadres. I have streamed through Google Plus Hangouts. And I've streamed on Ustream. And I've streamed on Ustream now for 3 years. And it's free. It is what it is. There's going to be commercials. If I ever win the lottery, I'll buy a channel without commercials. But in the meantime, we have commercials. But I like being able to chat with my friends online and talk to them. I can see the stream. I like the Ustream producer because I could add videos. I could show you my screen. I could show you pictures. I like that interface very much. And I like that when I'm done, I will go, I can check how my metrics did, how many people came and watched, and then I'm, with one push of a button, I can send this show over to YouTube and be done with it. Now, I don't have to download it and then convert it and then send it. I just push a button and it goes straight over to my YouTube. And if I want to do videos that are hidden from everybody, I can do that too. So thank you. I made this paper using my Delusions sprays from Ranger. I used the lime green, the bubble gum, the tangerine orange, and the white, and some water. And did it on just plain old white paper, sprayed and misted. Here's the orange and pink together. And here's some of the green and the white. Kind of wanted to go with some of the colors that I had used in my paints in the background. So that's where we went with that. Because I'd used some pink and some fuchsia, and then I'd used some orange spray mist to play with one of my stencils. And so that's what inspired those colors. And they're some of my favorite colors. So I'm using the scissor to just kind of push right there because, for whatever reason, those are getting a little persnickety on the edge there. Yes, really, really. Hopefully I used the right amount of strips. I've done it twice. Yes, I love delusions. I love gelatos. Did some color mist with some gelatos that I really enjoy. I got a prize pack from Rit Dyes in the mail today. Oh my goodness. Got lots of beautiful colors and some buttons and some fabric and some rubber bands. I'm very excited and anxious to do some stuff with that. I have plans already this weekend, or I would probably break that open and use it, but I will definitely use it pretty soon here because it's some great stuff. I was very lucky. Very excited that the Rit Dye folks selected me to win their product. So, okay. I have two more strips left. Can you believe it? Since it's almost 10 o'clock, I'm going to do these two strips. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in and I'm going to number them. And I'm going to number them on the outside. So my numbers will be on this side and on this side. And just for the purpose of kind of showing how this is going to work, I'll probably go in and put stuff on the first, 15. Delusions. It's from Ranger. And then I will do some work around my letters. I'm going to get out. I have a white paint pen. It's thin that I kind of like. I'll get that out and use it. And might do some black lettering, or not lettering, but patterning around the edge too. Okay, I really love this. I really love how that looks on there. But to help make my letters pop over here, I'm going to go around them with some white and maybe some black. I'm going to go down the edges here with numbers. And I might come over here and do a little doodling or something. I may leave this blank and this may be doodled further on in the year, but Rit Dye. I won a prize pack. It was pretty cool. So I will share that later. So, but anyway, so here you see there's a little bit of embossing going on there with my Delusions mask. And then these are all Delusion stamps. The paints are all built a ceramic coat and some fun stamps that I got at Walmart, and some of the stamps are some Echo dye ink, but love it. Love my strips. Love how that went together. No, it's not a white pit pen. This one is just a paint marker. This is something I picked up at Michael's. I would probably use my pit pens. I have some black pit pens, so I'll probably use that on my doodling on my letters though. So, but this just, it's a plain old skinny white paint pen, paint marker, fine tip, and it works pretty good. Thanks, Dawn. I'm glad I inspired you to play with your mists. I hope to see what you do. I know you'll probably stream this weekend when I'm off doing a party with a friend of ours, but I will catch you later. I have used Uniball white pens. I like them. Okay. They're fine. I do a lot of Zentangle, and so I have, I like the Pitt pens. I like the Staedtler pens. I have quite a collection of pens that I like to use for it. And then I'm taking a lettering class, which I can't wait to play with some more this weekend. And I needed a water-soluble pen that had a brush tip, and my Tombows, I only have like six Tombows total, they were not doing the job, and I needed a gray and that kind of stuff. And so I just picked up these Artist Loft pens at Michael's, and they're the Michael's store brand, and they actually do a pretty good job. I'm impressed with their generic brand. So I'd recommend, if you need some brush tip markers, these are pretty cool. And of course, now that I have almost all of the Spectrum Noir pens, they're coming out with a new pen that has a bigger barrel, and it's hexagon shaped and all this stuff, and it will have an alternate brush nib that you can put in it. So I'm hoping, see, I only have the darks left and they've been ordered. So I'm hoping the brush nib will work with the old pens. So I hope so. Just a white pen. I do like the Signal a lot. I also like the Sakura white pens. They're very nice, the Sakura of America pens. What I do like about the Pitt pens, is they have the India ink, but they also have like in browns and stuff. So those are very nice. But yeah, if I go for white, if I'm not using a paint pen like the paint marker, then I would use probably a Signo or the Sakura white pens. But those are both very nice pens. So that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. So if you don't have any other questions, I will let you guys go. I appreciate you coming for the show and hanging out with me while we do this. It's all nice and dry. Since it is all nice and dry and nothing's lifting up, I think I'm not gonna even bother going back over it with the fast finish decoupage. I'm gonna let it hang as it is, if that's okay. And then I'll show you one more time my project that I did for the blog this week for Altered Pages. This is my altered journal, and I give that to a friend so she can do some writing in it. And so that will be leaving my house. I hope I didn't just put it in pink paint. I did not. Yay me. So there you go. So I will talk to you later. Feel free, those of you who came in late, that this has been recorded. I'm gonna leave it out on Ustream for the weekend, and then on Sunday I'll blog about it and get it moved over to YouTube, so you can find it right where it is. And thank you for coming and spending your Friday evening with me. And everybody, have a super weekend. Love on your friends and family. That's what it's about. And I will see y'all in a couple of weeks. Good night.